With your Presto electric rotisserie turkey fryer, you can cook a moist, flavorful turkey indoors in about 60 minutes. Here's how to fry a whole turkey. For a frozen turkey, select one with a frozen tag weight that does not exceed 15 pounds. If you're frying a fresh whole turkey, the weight of the turkey should not exceed 12.5 pounds. Completely thaw a frozen turkey before you begin, following one of the methods found on page 7 of the instruction book. Remove the turkey from its wrappings and allow excess moisture to drain away. If the turkey comes with a pop-up thermometer, remove and discard it. If the turkey contains a gravy packet, remove it along with the neck and giblet package. Cut away the excess skin at the neck area following the contour of the breast. Pull out the white triangle-shaped piece of fat attached just above the neck stub and discard. This allows oil to circulate through the cavity while frying. If the legs are secured with a plastic or metal clip, remove and discard. Some brands secure the legs in a pocket of skin. If so, remove them from the pocket and cut away the skin to expose the tail. Cut away and discard the tail, excess skin, and fat so they do not interfere with the rotisserie. This will also enhance oil circulation. Using paper towels, dry both the outside and the cavity of the turkey. Lift the legs and wings and dry between all the creases. If you feel ice crystals under the skin, additional thawing is necessary. It is very important to dry the turkey completely. Next, the turkey needs to be trussed to ensure the legs and wings do not interfere with the rotisserie. Using the included butcher's twine, cut one 12-inch long piece and two 42-inch long pieces. With the turkey breast side up, center one of the longer pieces of twine under the turkey in the area below the wings. Tuck the wing tips in the creases between the legs and the breasts and bring the ends of the twine up and around the widest part of the wings. Tie the twine tightly using a surgeon's knot. Loop one end of the twine under the other 2 times. Cinch it tightly and finish by tying a half knot over the top. Cut off excess twine so it does not become entangled during rotation. Reposition the wingtips as needed so they are under the twine. Center the remaining long piece of twine under the turkey in the area below the thighs. Bring the ends of the twine up and around the widest part of the leg and thigh. Once again, loop one end of the twine under the other 2 times, cinch, and finish with a half knot. Cut off any excess twine. Secure the legs by crisscrossing the knob ends and tying them together tightly using the shorter piece of twine. Once again, cut off any excess twine. Place the turkey on a paper towel-lined cookie sheet or baking pan to allow the turkey's internal temperature to increase before frying. While the turkey is resting, assemble the fryer by placing the base in the center of the countertop. Make sure the area is clean, dry, level, and stable. Position the removable pot in the base so the word rear is on the end opposite of the drain brace. Attach the control assembly to the base by aligning the 2 guides on the front of the control panel with the 2 tracks on the exterior of the base, and slide the control assembly down as far as it goes. Make sure both guides are in the tracks. Next, assemble the rotisserie. It consists of these parts: the pivot handle assembly, which contains the engagement switch, chain, and pivot plate, the skewer, and the lifting handle assembly. Begin by lubricating the chain side of the pivot plate. Using a paper towel, apply a very light coating of cooking oil from the edge of the plate toward the center, about 1/2 inch. Be sure to rotate the plate as you apply oil, so the entire circumference of the plate is lubricated. Next, attach the skewer to the pivot plate. Holding the pivot handle in one hand, with the chain facing out, rotate the pivot plate so the lock channel is parallel to the handle. Release the lock spring by squeezing the ends. Rotate the spring away from the lock channel. Using your other hand, grip the closed end of the skewer and slide the pointed ends through the loops in the plate. Continue sliding the skewer until the bent ends touch the loops. Carefully lift and rotate the skewer so the closed end rests in the lock channel. Lock the skewer in place by returning the lock spring to its original position. Squeeze the ends of the spring to secure each side in its lock channel hook. The turkey is now ready to be skewered. Before skewering, use paper towels to dry any additional moisture that has accumulated in the turkey cavity. Place the turkey on the counter with the breast side facing up. Position the pivot handle assembly so the pivot plate is resting on the counter and the skewer ends are just below the turkey legs. Grasp the pivot handle assembly, lift the drumstick slightly, and center the skewer points beneath the legs. While keeping the skewer parallel with the counter, push the skewer straight through the middle of the turkey. Carefully push the skewer fully through the turkey's length until the pointed ends protrude from the neck end. Next, the turkey is locked onto the skewer to complete the rotisserie assembly. The lifting handle contains the locking plate. There are metal locking tabs on each side of the plate that move up and down. Each tab has a keyhole slot. When the tabs are moved so the round end of the keyhole slots are in the center of the locking plate, the plate is in the unlocked position and the skewers can be inserted or removed. When moved so the small end is at the center, the plate is locked and the skewers cannot be inserted or removed. Align the two skewer guides on the locking plate with the pointed skewer ends. Push the plate onto the skewer ends until the stop tabs are against the skewer guides. Slide both locking tabs to lock the skewer in place. Always verify that the skewer is locked in place by firmly pulling on the lifting handle. It is important that the turkey be centered correctly on the skewer for the rotisserie to rotate properly. That can be a challenge because turkeys vary greatly in shape. Some are lopsided. To be sure the skewered turkey is centered properly, perform a dry run before adding oil to the fryer. Check to be sure the rotisserie engagement switch on the pivot handle is in the off position. Before attaching the rotisserie, make sure the motor switch and the temperature control knob on the control panel are both in the off position. Lift the skewered turkey using the pivot handle and the lifting handle. Position the rotisserie over the fryer so the pivot handle, the one with the ProFry logo, is above the control panel. Lower the pivot handle into the recessed area of the control panel until it is resting securely in place. Lower the turkey into the fryer until the frying hooks on the lifting handle rest on the fryer rim. It is important that the hooks are placed over the rim, otherwise the rotisserie will not fully rotate. Then, attach the power cord to the fryer by aligning the magnetic plug with the pins on the back of the control panel. Plug the cord into a 120-volt AC electrical wall outlet and the power light will illuminate. Turn the motor button to on and slide the rotisserie engagement switch to the on position. The rotisserie will engage and the turkey will start to rotate. Allow the turkey to rotate for one or two complete revolutions, making sure it rotates fully and does not come in contact with the inside of the fryer. If the turkey rotates fully, the skewer is properly centered and the turkey is ready for frying. If it does not rotate fully, it is not centered properly or the turkey was not tied properly. In either case, turn the motor switch to the off position. Then push the rotisserie engagement switch to the off position. Sometimes the switch may be difficult to push due to tension on the rotisserie chain. Moving the lifting handle from side to side on the rim of the fryer or lifting the handle slightly relieves the tension. Grasping both the pivot handle and the lifting handle, remove the turkey and rotisserie from the fryer and place them on a paper towel-lined cookie sheet or baking pan. If the turkey did not rotate fully, check to see if the twine is pulled tight and retie if necessary. Then, move the locking tabs on the lifting handle to the unlocked position and detach the handle from the skewer by pulling on the handle. Pull the skewer from the turkey and reinsert it, paying special attention to properly centering the skewer. Reattach the lifting handle and return the assembly to the fryer and try another dry run. Repeat until the turkey rotates fully. Once proper rotation has been achieved, remove the turkey and rotisserie from the fryer and place them on a paper towel-lined cookie sheet or baking pan. Before pouring oil into the removable pot, be sure that it is completely dry. Fill the removable pot with vegetable oil up to the turkey line, which is 1 gallon. Peanut oil is preferred because of its high smoke point. If you like, you can fill the fryer up to the max line using an additional 1/3 gallon of oil, but don't exceed the max line. Place the cover on the fryer with the vents toward the control panel. Turn the temperature control to 375 degrees. The oil ready light will go on and the oil will begin to heat. If the ready light does not turn on, a likely cause is a sensor that automatically shuts the fryer off if it has been overheated. This can occur if the unit was accidentally heated without oil during the dry run. Check that the fryer is cool and then use the tip of a Phillips screwdriver to press the red reset button on the back of the control panel. When the selected temperature is reached, the oil ready light will go out. It will take about 20 minutes. When the fryer is preheated, remove the cover. The turkey can now be fried. Before attaching the rotisserie, make sure the motor switch on the control panel is in the off position. Lift the skewered turkey using the pivot handle and the lifting handle. Position the rotisserie over the fryer so the pivot handle, the one with the ProFry logo, is above the control panel. Lower the pivot handle into the recessed area of the control panel until it is resting securely in place. Lift the drain brace so it is against the fryer rim and carefully lower the lifting handle until the drain hooks are resting on the brace. If desired, the cover may be placed over the turkey before lowering it into the oil to reduce initial spattering. Place the cover so it rests on both handles with the cover vents toward the rotisserie switch. If the cover is used when lowering the turkey, it must be removed after 1 to 2 minutes. Do not cook the turkey with the cover on. To lower the turkey, raise the lifting handle slightly and push the drain brace so it falls back against the fryer. Very slowly, lower the turkey into the fryer until the frying hooks on the lifting handle rest on the fryer rim. It is important that the hooks are placed over the rim. Otherwise, the rotisserie will not fully rotate. Turn the motor button to on and slide the rotisserie engagement switch to the on position. The rotisserie will engage and the turkey will start to rotate. Begin timing and allow about 4 minutes cooking time per pound of turkey based on the weight when purchased. Periodically, check the turkey to be sure it is rotating properly. When the frying time has elapsed, allow the turkey to rotate until the breast side is up. Turn the motor switch to the off position and insert a meat thermometer into the thickest part of the breast without contacting a bone. The turkey is safely cooked if the internal temperature is at least 165 degrees Fahrenheit. If it is not, continue frying. If it is, turn the temperature control to off and remove the plug from the wall and then the fryer. Push the rotisserie engagement switch to the off position. Sometimes the switch may be difficult to push due to tension on the rotisserie chain. Moving the lifting handle from side to side on the rim of the fryer or lifting the handle slightly relieves the tension. Raise the lifting handle with one hand and the drain brace with the other, so it is resting on the fryer rim. Carefully set the lifting handle drain hooks on the drain brace. Keep the turkey in this drain position for a minute or two to allow hot oil to drain from the turkey cavity. Meanwhile, line a large clean tray or cookie sheet with paper towels. Grasping both the pivot handle and the lifting handle, carefully lift the turkey out of the fryer and set it on the paper towel lined tray. Allow it to rest for about 15 minutes before removing it from the rotisserie. Using paper towels or hot pads, move the locking tabs on the lifting handle to the unlocked position and pull the handle away from the skewer. Holding the turkey firmly with either a carving fork in the turkey breast or folded paper towels, pull the skewer from the turkey and remove the twine. You can now carve your turkey and enjoy it.